Evening, everyone. It's a few minutes after 6, and this is your closing comment. It is video number 615, and we'd really appreciate it if you like the work. Just hit the subscribe button. It's very supportive of us. Okay, so today was a kind of an interesting day. I'll leave the GameStop stuff till the end, because who knows where it'll be by then. We had the Apple earnings, and the stock was down $4.97, 3.5%, down at, it was a little lower, but this was actually a great number and a great report. Facebook was $2.65, down $7.14, 2.6%, and Tesla, which reported another gain, actually closed 835.43, down 28.73 or 3.3% after trading all the way down to 772 last night after the numbers. American Airlines, which was another one of those stocks that looked like it was really taking off, no pun intended there, sorry, and it had earnings that were poor, but not as badly as expected. The stock traded as high as $29 in the pre-market, but could only manage $21.77 in the real world. And it finished the day at $18.10, up $1.54 after being up 11. And in late trading tonight, it's $18.95, up $2.36 on the day. MasterCard and Visa reported after the close tonight. Neither of them were particularly good. Again, lower, but better than worst fears. Visa closed at 198.22 before the earnings, up 3.25, and is currently trading 201, up $6.03. And they have also issued they're going to start a new share repurchase, $5.8 billion. I just can't believe how tone deaf some of these companies are. MasterCard also lower than, better than feared, and it's down 18 cents. Okay, we had also this morning, we had Dow Chemical and we had McDonald's, and both Dow Chemical and McDonald's were basically unchanged today, even though McDonald's missed top and bottom line and Dow beat top and bottom line. Dow actually was down 1 penny on the day. McDonald's down 18 cents. Two big winners, though, earnings-wise and percentage gain-wise. Comcast beat top and bottom and was up $3.18 at the close at $51.60, currently trading $51.30, down 30 cents. And Big Steel, for people who actually remember when that's what it was called, beat top and bottom line. And that one is up 9.3% at $20.10, up $1.72. Okay, GameStop. I'm not going to get into all the politics of what happened today with Robinhood and some of the other firms, but the stock was traded as high as 518 pre-market. In the real world, after it actually opened, the high for the day was 483. The low for the day was 112.25. It was constantly being stopped for volatility, and it closed today 193.60, down about $154. But after the close, several of the firms that had said that you can't buy it on margin or they're not accepting certain kinds of trades in it went back on their word and said, yes, we're going to open it back up tomorrow. Whereupon the stock turned from that 194 area and is currently 295, up 101 from the close. AMC was also all over the place today. It was a high of $16.50 and a low of $6.15. And it closed the day at $11.50, down $8.41. This, as far as I'm concerned, is the only company that did what they should. And that was, as the stock was moving higher, they raised $305 million on a stock offering. That will help them dramatically, mostly because they had taken down $917 million in debt stock issuance, and one of those was $100 million from a vulture fund, I've mentioned this before, which was at 15% and had to start being paid back July 1st. So they get from out from under that, they get $305 million in the raise, and I'm assuming the first thing they're going to do is retire that $100 million. I'm sure there's some sort of penalty, but the fact is it's not 15%, so they actually make out better. The market today was as high as up 636. It closed up only half of that, 300.19, which was just under 1% up. NASDAQ was also much higher, but it was kind of subdued all day because of the Tesla, Facebook, Apple all being down. It finished up 66.56, 0.5%, and the S&P was up 36, or right around the same as the NYSE. 0.98%. The Russell did very little of anything, down $2. And the Dow Jones Transports, which really have gotten killed the last 4 or 5 days, they were down about 900 in that time frame, actually was up today 1%, which is really kind of meager. You know, up 127 after being down 900 in a week is really not much. Market internals were really interesting today. The NYSE was 2.3 to 1 up, which is pretty good. And the NASDAQ was only 1.3 to 1 up. And the volume was explosive. Volume was almost twice what it's been recently, and that of course is based on the fact that we had these short targets trading tremendously. I don't remember what the number is today, but yesterday I believe it was AMC, which has 107 million shares outstanding, traded 1.3 billion shares. So, you know, you look at a market that is normally trading 4 or 5 or even 6 billion shares a day, and you add 20% to it, that's a pretty big number. Okay, the chart on the screen is the silver, and if you're a subscriber, you know that we bought the calls for the silver yesterday, right before the close, at 64 cents, and this morning when the silver opened up, we sold them between basically $2.25 and $2.45 a piece. So that was a great gain. The gold was actually down 770, while the silver, which was up over $1.30 during the day, finished up 53 cents, and still a decent day. And we also had the oil down a half a dollar. We're short the oil. And we had the net gas down a bit. And we're long that gas. So that's kind of an interesting juxtaposition. Bitcoin was kind of interesting. It actually looks like it's really trying to hold in the area that we are. It's really been kind of weak. Let's see, where are we? Here we go. Bitcoin, it's up 830 tonight. But more specifically, it came down today all the way to, again, test this area. The low for the day was 29,860. So below that 30,000 into the support that we pointed out 2 weeks ago or a week and a half ago, and finished near the high. And then tonight, as I said, is up 8.30. Bonds were down about a point, and the U.S. dollar was down 21 cents. So, a little bit surprising to see the gold act as poorly as it did versus the others. Tonight it's up $4 at 18.45, while the silver is up 68 cents. Those are pretty big numbers. Just to give you an idea of how out of line that actually is, gold is up 0.23%, so a quarter of a percent. And the silver, at the same time, is up 67.3 cents on $25, and that is a move of 2.5%. That is literally 10 times the move to the upside in the silver as the gold. So we'll be watching that carefully. Okay, just so that you know, tomorrow there are some economic numbers and also some earnings. On the earnings front, we have Colgate, Eli Lilly, Caterpillar, CVX, which is Chevron, and Honeywell. And on economic numbers, we have personal income and spending, fourth quarter employment index, the Chicago PMI, pending home sales, and the Michigan Consumer Sentiment Survey. So there you have it, and I'll be back first thing in the morning. Have a good evening, and don't forget to subscribe.